都覆盖到啊，大致上就是 roughly。Let's list the key words that you find that are more related to technical people. 你觉得哪些形容词比较适合、比较符合技术人员的一个词？Logical, okay. 就是逻辑性强啊。Logical, okay. 还有。
Accurate, okay.
就精确。
还
有。Analytical, okay. 就是分析力强。还有。
Logical,
刚才讲过了。Logical, okay. 就是这个知识点教。Challenging is, 如果尤其是我们看中文也是可以啊、look at the Chinese translation, sometimes more provocative, 敢于挑战，就不仅是敢于接触挑战，而且敢于挑战他人。可能有些了，再说了，不是特别多。还有吗？
Perfectionist
就完美主义啊，就是我。那大致上呢，我们可以这么来说啊。我们可以就说那个什么黄色这一边啊，基本上就相对于技术人比较多啊，所以我们有的说那个说技术完美，甚至于什么我们说一心一意，我们可以如果说大家可以看一本的，就有些时候技术人员的一些缺点比较什么不是很通，尤其是怎么样技术人员呢？尤其你在做生产，especially if you're in production，因为你这个东西就是需要定时定点。然后按照一定的这个计划不能随意更改 ，but everything has to go to plan. You don't change the plan, any way you like. 所以有时候造成有时候就比较 inflexible. Okay. 那这边应该不是凹沟，应该是红色的啊，就应该是倒转。有些技术会比较 original， 就是独特的一个想法。Okay. 那。如果说比较不像技术人员，比较不像那种红色的、啊，就是什么 aggressive 啊，比较不像技术人员。然后还有什么 caring， this is unlike technical people、不是说技术人员比较冷血啊，不关怀他人，而是技术人员的关怀好像人家感受不到的，不是这样。So it's not that you're not caring, it's just that people don't feel the warmth of your caring as technical people.还有呢，技术员一般上也不是善于合作。And it's cooperative usually， 为什么呢？It's not a technical person trait。为什么呢？很多时候都是自己做自己，甚至于 everybody just do their own thing。甚至于我们这么来想，我们这边有没有人做？有没有是那个研发部的 ？Anyone from R&D？ 研发部啊 ，OK， 你最后再问一下研发部啊。你会不会为你的那个什么我们销售部门的业绩负责？No, you should be responsible for the sales results of the sales department. No, right? And this is precisely why a very big, famous, popular company went from the best-selling company in the world until now it's no longer in existence.对，就是我们为什么有一个非常著名的一家企业，我们这家企业这品牌估计家喻户晓，但是在短短几年间突然间没有了，谁呢？
诺基亚。
Nokia, right? So the story of Nokia， 我们就简单讲一个诺基亚的一个简短一个八卦的故事啊。The story of Nokia is， 我们那个什么 iPhone 一代什么时候出来 ？iPhone one， 那个 iPhone one come up。零七年，我跟你讲，那个 iPhone One 都是 in China， 因为 iPhone 一代的时候啊，国内版就是过，对吧 ？iPhone One was not formally in China. You can only get parallel imports from Hong Kong or from somewhere else. But iPhone One came out in 2007，2007年 iPhone 一代推出，随之什么事情发生 ？After iPhone One, what happened？We have Samsung, right? We have FTC, HTC, right? We got HTC and other brands who are similar in the sense that we have smartphones. 我们这个什么智能电话推出来，就是触屏电话，具体到触屏电话出来。Okay, so we have the smartphone revolution. So from 2007 一四年就签字了。The agreement was more or less set in 2013, right? Signed and taken over on 2014. So that's about last couple of years, 就是前两年，零七年到一三年，
六年
，six years， 这零七年破以前最畅销的手机品牌，你估计啊 ？Right, Total Seven before Total Seven best-selling brand is Nokia. Not just in Total Seven, but accumulated numbers, it's got the most units sold ever. 就是说，我们手机的，如果我们按钱，如果按那个你卖了多少的那个金额，你按卖了多少件 ，by volume， 卖有史至今卖了最多台手机的，还是目前。The most number of units of phone sold is still Nokia to date. 这情况。Now what happened briefly is that when 2007 happened, we had the iPhones, we got all the Android phones, it all came in, and Nokia salespeople complained to R&D. 那诺基亚那个销售人员就是受到 iPhone 啊、安卓啊冲击，就投诉他们那个研发部。就说什么，我们研发什么塞班，我们就现在那个客户不要塞班，你能不能搞一些这是触屏版的，我们好卖一点。Okay, so the sales complained to R&D and say that everybody wants touch screens, right? We don't want symbian phones. Customers don't want symbian phones. Can you R&D develop some touch screen for us? We can't sell them all. Right? 那结果他们研发部的这个答复是什么？他们研发部就有一句话：销售是你们销售的职责。Right? Sales is the responsibility.Sales results is the responsibility of the sales department. 研发部嘛，只要负责研发目前最好的这个手机 OS， 也就是塞班。So R&D is only responsible for developing the best OS, mobile phone OS in the world, which is Symbian. 如果你们这个销售如果做得不好，那是你们销售不争气。Right, if your sales figures go down, then your sales are not doing your job. 销售没做好就不做。OK, 那我们研发部呢，我们只是负责我们该做的事情。We in R&D just focus on what we need to do. Okay, so that was actually something that came up from Nokia X Nokia stuff. 就是过去的一些诺基亚的一些员工就是有这样子一个反馈。结果短短六年。就因为各做各的 ，it's uncooperative. You think of what we need to do, you do what you do. I don't care what you do, you don't care what we do. 我不去参谋你做什么，你也井水不犯河水，你也不去跟我做什么，各做各的。结果我们那个诺基亚就在短短六年间就完了。This is six years, the best selling mobile phone brand in the world goes out of business. 短短六年，你说？
I have some question. Okay.Mm-hmm. So for these, all of these characteristics,
yes.
How do you think about the speed drops? Is it practical people, or sales people, or weird people?
It's a weird people.
Weird people.
Weird There's people only one
weird
job.
Weird people can be the world.
我们说乔布斯到底是怎么样一个风格啊？我们大致上的一个特点啊，他原创度特别强。哎，说到 Steve Jobs， 报告一下 Steve Jobs。原创度特别强，还有呢，完美主义特别强 ，perfectionist， 还有呢
，aggressive， no caring，
yeah caring， no care doesn't care。Well， actually， Steve Jobs know how to hurt people most。乔布斯如果是骂人，他真的会用专门用那些词语，就是找到那些词语，真的是能刺痛你的词语。专门就是骂人特别土的，特别英雄，不完美。I can say innovative, I can say tough and all that. OK， 这乔布斯一些特点，他能看到别人看不到的机会。Right, so it's not a technical person because he really is not a technical person. 乔布斯真的不是技术人，他技术能力真的很差，他是略懂一点，但真的不是 technical。Knowledge is very limited. he is in a way a kind of salesperson. 他销售还相当的强。他的那个感染力啊，他那个什么，他知道怎么去把这个什么怎么样的一种情况能够体现给他。But more than that is more like a weird person， 还是比较独特的，比较怪的。Right, so that's the job. Now, let's look at salespeople. 如果是销售人员，又有怎么样的一个要求？So for this， 我们这方面就用了一个岗位测评。We use a job role analysis for this. Right, and the background for the description words just now and the job role analysis is based on a system called Melvin.我们这一个叫贝尔宾，原先是做那个团队的一个角色分析，我们前面的那些形容词都从贝尔宾那边的就是导过来。另外一方面呢，我们也可以就是做一个岗位的分析，一个岗位按照你这个岗位在这家企业应该体现哪些方面的一些特质，你才能做出来。What are some of the characteristics that you need to have, not just for the job, but for the job in your company?所以这样是按照不同的企业可能会有一些不同的一些情况。So we have this client， 我们有这个客户，那他们那时候在招一个不仅是销售，而且是驻外的区域销售。It's not just sales， but a SOHO regional sales。一个人在自己家里办公，然后覆盖另一个自己的区域。So that was that kind of sales。So for them， that was what they're looking for。那这边是英文的，就用中文简单这个翻译吧。我们那时候做的英文版。这些工作啊，基本上就需要就是有些人的那个什么探索能力 ，need some of exploratory skills。探索就是基本上你骨头比较要找鸡蛋里要找到骨头啊，就有石头就要翻过来。You need to leave no stone unturned， 来就探索能力啊。第二呢，就是你的什么？你要出去，然后能够去见人，然后去找去新的契机，找去新的可能性，就是基本上外向找机会。Right, for technical people, this is very different. 因为技术人员通常什么，人家给你一个框架，你按照这个框架来做出什么一些事情。这个是没框架，你去外面找个线索，自己搭个框架。Right, in technical work, it's like people give you a structure, you get a scope. Within the scope, you got a deliverable. Whereas for here, there's no scope. You go up there, find possibilities and create your own scope.
其实这有它一个本质的区别。
这工作需要就是有人就是他有一个什么强烈的自我激励的一个 quality， 他的一个自我推动力的 strong driving qualities。就是说你不是靠因为你去公司要打卡，因为你看到老板，因为老板给你的任务，而是你自己要自觉自发的去找出机会。Right, this job not because you have something to do, your boss gives you something to do, you need to punch your card, it's you need to have that initiative. 还有呢，这个候选人们应该就是能够有就是排除万难 overcome opposition， 有这个自信，而且就是能够就是。遇到任何的阻碍都能够就是搞定任何阻碍 ，overcome obstacles, have confidence。还有呢，就你是一个就是 high achiever 啊，就基本上就是能够有自我激励的达到最高最好的一个结果。还有除此之外呢，如果你是技术型销售 ，if you're a technical sale， 你还需要就是能够注意到细节。精准度，还有就是质量的管理。If you're non-technical sale, maybe this is not important. But if you're technical sale, 如果你是那个技术型销售，那你还不能够只是一个人梯啊，到处找人，到处去忽悠人，去跟人家就凑合来，你还要就是粗中带细。You need to also focus on details, besides the ongoing. 然后你的那个什么说服能力啊，说话是不是能够会说服人，说服能力。是不是一定强？还有呢，这工作嘛是一个类似于创业型的一个角色。什么创业型呢？就把这工作当成自己一门小生意。You take a role as if it's a little small little business for yourself。
就是 outstation 的一个学校，因为你是驻外的一个就是 SOHO 的一个项目，你需要就是去找寻不同的一个机会啊，因为在前面也提过，只要你找到有一个就是契机，有一个这突破口，你必须就是花就是很大很大的一个精力，所有精力把来把这个可能性变成一个现实。You need to make things happen。这个工作嘛的那个社交方面的一些维度非常强，那你在其他人眼中的这个形象也很重要。You need to be the way you are seen by others is important。你需要就是能够独立啊，是执行啊，stand on feet。而且呢，就是有什么事情，基本上你需要就是有个人的担当。You cannot blame others for mistakes. You need to take personal responsibility. 然后呢，你有些时候需要就是独立能够做决策，因为有些客户就会问你很多问题。You need to make decisions on your own, not rely on others. 所以你需要就是在客户面前，你需要独立能够做合适的决策。So this is some of things. And also, some of key qualities that we have.有些就是比较重要的一些特质啊，包括什么 believer 这样的适应力要强，enterprise 就是说你是不是有一种做生意的一种商务的一个开发能力啊，enterprise 自力更生，然后 competitive 就是能够就争这么一口气，就是有些人活着是为了什么争口饭，有些人对挣口饭啊，就是有些人活着是嘛干嘛的？争口气啊，这有时候是争口气，就是 very competitive kind of nature, one way, and seize opportunities, 就别不要说等人家给你机会，你就要争取机会。但 it's not the opportunity, but seize opportunities. Okay, so that's a key qualities. 还有后面呢，就是哪些方面比较不可取呢 ？Inflexible 就不灵活 ，indecisive 或者这个什么优柔寡断啊，就害怕失败。为什么说害怕失败？这也是我们那个技术活跟销售活的一个区别。不敢尝试，一种是不敢尝试 ，afraid to try out things, try out new ideas，and also afraid of rejection。另外一个是害怕人家的拒绝，跟这有两层意义啊。一个是我做一个尝试，结果失败；另外一种意义就是我去找到客户，结果客户把我拒绝。这两种都是这个失败。但做销售是这样子，做销售的工作跟技术工作 difference between the sales job and the technical job is this， 技术的工作你的结果几乎是100%你可以控制。Right, the technical work you more or less can control 100% of the output。你如果设备好 ，if the machine is good， if the process is good。你的 skills is good because you got good skills, good process, good machinery, good equipment. You got a good outcome. 哎，你的那个，你只要把所有东西放在一块，流程对的，基本上你的结果肯定是好的。这是技术。销售工作呢 ，sales job very different. 如果我们一般销售，不管是我们自己还是我们的销售同事 ，regardless whether it's ourselves as technical sales or any。Sales colleagues or any sales team out there in the world, 一般的一个销售情况。Out of 100 new customers that you approach, how many of them can you close by the end of 3 years? 如果你是一般的这个销售团队，找寻了100个新客户，在3年的期限里面，你能够就是做成多少的这个新客户？不管是技术还是非技术，就是 general 的 ，it doesn't matter if it's technical not technical， but out of 100 new customers with a deadline of 3 years， how what is the percentage of the new customers you can close at the end of 3 years？
5
少了一点，悲观一点，还能再更会怎么？Between 10 to 15，差不多10%到15%左右。这是 normal 的 average。如果你是好销售，你叫 good sales，you'll be able to close around 30% by the end of 3 years。尤其是工业，especially for industrial products。 因为你销售周期可能比较长啊，所以就给一个3年左右的一个期限，差不多了，3年能成也就成，3年成不了估计也太长。
Okay, and with 3 years, the deal is if you are not able to close in 3 years, usually it's not possible. Right? So if a good salesperson closes 30% of new customers with a 3-year timeline, what is the failure rate? 如果一个好的销售能做成30%的这个新客户，他的失败的那个概率是多少？70%, 70% failure rate. Now, in technical work, 如果你在做技术工作，你有1%的失败率就很严重。In technical work, you got 1% failure rate, that's bad. 你这边有人做那个6个西格玛 ,6 西格玛。你刚才做了99.99%嘛，就是那个精确度，就是 accuracy is 99.99% of software, right? It's 99.99%, right? 这才叫做好的技术。你换到销售的另外一个侧重点，你的那个 failure 就是，你如果 fail 70%，你算好销售。If you fail 70% of time, you are good sales, right? If you are a legend.如果你是传说 ，you will fail 50% of the time。这传说就也顶多就是50%的这个失败率。什么叫50%失败率？你每见2个客户，有一个就能成交，这个传说。That will be legend if you can. Every 2 customers you meet, one will be a real customer. This is legend, unbelievable.哎，这个还都有50%的这个失败率，都还有 failure rate of 50%。这也是工作方面的一个区别。It's a different in job nature. So you cannot be frightened of failure. You cannot be say I prepare everything. Only I'm fully prepared, then I do something. 你不能那么做。但是呢，这话说回来 ，But in terms of technical people become sales people.There is an advantage. 销售人员如果是非技术的销售人员，他们最缺什么 ？What do non-technical sales lack the most? 非技术的销售人员最缺什么？
不懂自己的产品
什么 ？Don't know the product, don't know technical things. Okay, 这还有What else?
给大家一个提示吧，就最缺的是计划
，lack planning.怎么样进行计划？不是说就简单的了解这个市场情况，了解客户信息，不用简单总结。Such as about understand your market, understand your background information of the customer. 你在做销售之前，有些时候你就需要考虑这个客户，我应该问些什么，我要怎么来问，怎么样的一个沟通比较合适，这些都需要做计划的。Maybe you need to think about if you want to go into a meeting with a customer.You gotta think about, you know, what question should I ask? How should I phrase it? How can I drive the conversation? This requires planning. Most salespeople don't do that. 他们的销售都基本上就是忽略，就是最后什么，进有了客户立刻报进口。哎，这个 appointment is just carry their bags and see the customer. Don't think about what they want to do in class. Just give an example. 再拿了一个典故吧。几年前我们也做一些团队建设的一些活动，户外活动，就是 outdoor team building。几年前的一个比较流行的一个项目叫 GCS。A few years ago, we got this laser strike. They were shooting using laser. Future from very long. 如果我们这个项目，当然我们要做这个项目啊，必须有个底部啊，要不然不能卖给企业。We need to have a backstory to put the counter strike into the team building game. 所以我们的那个背景故事是，我们工作人员会扮演恐怖分子，然后就在一个贼窝里面，然后客户那边的人呢，就是去围剿恐怖分子，然后自己也确保不会被打死。Right? So we our staff will be the terrorists, and terrorists will be hiding somewhere.And then the participants will be the people who will go around to kill all the terrorists without getting themselves killed. Right, so that was basically the plan. We say we need to have strategy, we need planning, 战略有策略啊，什么都有。So if we were to do this with technical people, 如果我们是一群技术人员做这样子的活动，
而如果我们不去阻止他们的话，他们要策划计划多久才会出发？ If we do this with a technical people, and if we don't stop them, how long do you think it will take to analyze and plan the whole situation? 估计 half an hour, 不是真的那个 technical people. 那个很 technical people, it's very technical people, very specialized technical people.I believe if we don't stop them, it'll take 3 days to get such a thing. What will be the first thing that they will plan? 第一个会研究什么？枪。They will analyze the equipment, the gun. Right? 怎么样瞄怎么打才准 ？Right? They'll analyze everything. Right? How to make sure the proper aiming is all in low condition. Right? So they'll plan everything before they go up.On the other hand, 另外一方面啊，如果这是一群销售人员，会有什么样的结果？你别这，要是 team a bunch of sales people, what will happen? Just go and拎了家伙就上，对吧？然后上到前面才发现不知道那枪不知道怎么用，然后就一下子被打死。Right, they just bring the gun, go up there, and they just realize that they don't know how to operate it, and they all get killed. Right, so that sales people.所以这是两种的一种那种特性。So when we become technical sales, it's good to have elements of both. 你有两者的一个结合，你是需要去行动，你不行动你做不了销售。Need action, without action you can't be sales. But at the same time, 如果你的那个技术的一个一方面，比如说一个 technical traits, 你知道怎么去分析，怎么去计划，怎么去步步为营 ，how to have a good procedure to guarantee better success for you. 那你的那个胜算其实会比较高。所以有些时候，刚才我们不是说，你要发挥你的强项，making use of your strengths. 技术人员的强项不仅是技术本身。那个 technical person, your strengths in sales is not only limited to your technical knowledge.你的那个记那个想象，有些时候在里面，就前面讲的，你的分析能力，哎，这个计划能力，哎，所以有 strengths 啊，有 analytical skills, the planning skills, and so this are things that are lacking in a lot of salespeople and technical salespeople may be doing better. And this is why we found some of the technical company, 有些技术型企业，它的那个技术有些是做 sales engineer.这是什么？这个叫销售工程师。The sales engineers they don't do the sales. They don't have sales targets, right? They only help sales in the engineering the technical part. 它只是一种就是辅助的给予客户的一些建议这样的工作。这个人群如果他转为销售，他们反而发现那个业绩比他们正规的销售还要强。For this technical company, it's an IT company. The sales engineer originally they don't carry sales targets. They only go solve the engineering problem for the sales colleagues. This bunch of people, if they were convinced to sales, they find that they usually outperform the regular sales people. And the reasons of 就像刚才就大家分享就种种的一些原因啊，就在那。怎么去调整呢？ Obviously, there are things that we need to learn how to actually make the transition. 我们要需要去知道怎么去调整。那这个调整里面基本上就在于我们的态度。When you want to adapt to sales or successful sales, a lot depends on your attitude. 那态度里面基本上我们可以就是分为大致上两种态度，一种叫什么？积极态度。还有什么呢？消极态度 ，positive attitude 和 negative attitude 的two kinds of attitude。什么叫积极态度？积极态度嘛，就是什么？遇到问题，你想办法解决，不是说你一定有办法解决，而是你会尽量想办法解决。Right, if you have positive attitude, if you have a problem, you'll try to find out a way to resolve the problem. It doesn't mean that you can't resolve the problem, but the attitude is.I will try. 就是我尽量办，我可能只能解决局部， 可能我暂时没办法解决，可能要有一定的一些条件我才能解决，但我毕竟想要解决。Try to resolve, I may not be able to do it, I may be only to partially, the time is not right, but I try. 另外一种叫什么呢？问题不是制造的，问题带来者。People who bring problems. 也就是说，当一个人遇到问题，他就跟他老板说，老板，我遇到问题，你来帮我解决。My boss, I have a problem. Can you solve me? That's right. 就是基本上把这个问题丢给老板。OK, 基本上就有一种积极态度，一个消极态度。如果说你遇到问题，你愿意去尝试解决，那基本上很多东西都可以逐渐改善。所以呢 ，if the attitude is more positive and you have problems and try to resolve them, you won't say that all problems can be resolved, but say that things usually can be better. 通常能够得到改善。OK, 所以这基本上就我们有时候要想想，我们符合是您是哪一类型？就是有时候这我们有时候需要自己做一些反省的工作。那从这边我们再看就是下一个主题啊，就是说为何有些技术销售能成，但其他才能不成 ？Why some sales people succeed, when others fail？ 首先，我们先去了解客户 ，OK？ 客户什么情况？客户要求销售什么 ？What do customers expect sales people to do？ 首先就是客户需要销售为客户的绩效承担个人责任。这些不是我们自己瞎蒙起来 ，It's not something that we just came up。这些是这边有一家就是咨询公司的research company called HR Chat， 他们是用了十几年访问了8万多家全球性的这个客户，从客户角度觉得说怎么样的销售是他们比较心仪的销售。这是 research that interviewed about 80,000-ish customers all around the world。Asking customers what makes a good salesperson from the customer's point of view, 这从客户角度出发。So the first one, 就是 be personally accountable for sales for the customer's results, 就基本上你要为客户的所有结果负责。如果你不信的话，我们这样子啊，就那些我们已经做销售的同仁，我们就问这么一句话：如果你客户你卖的产品如果出了一些闪失 ，right? If the product that you sell has got some problems, whether it's quality, delivery, whatever problem. 因为这产品可能出了一些闪失，质量还是运输问题。客户是打你们客服的这个热线4080号，还是打你手机？Customers will always call your mobile phone， 对吧？我不管这个东西是你们生产的问题、物流的问题、财务的问题，这不管，反正我出了问题，我怎么样？我找你，你帮我搞定。Right, so customers will only call the salesperson. They don't care whether the problem is someone department's problem. They want the salesperson to take care of everything. 所以就我为客户的绩效承担个人责任，就老在头上。为什么呢？为什么会有这样的情况？我们不是客服部，从技术人员有时候我们不了解，是吧？因为我们不是有客服嘛，这客户应该是找客服嘛。我这个销售已经不是我的事，我已经交接给客服了，这对口应该客服才对，干嘛要找我 ？Sometimes as technical people we don't understand, it's the wrong logic. Right now we got customer service. I've done the sale. Everything else is customer service's job. Customers are supposed to find customer service, not me. Why? What happened?
我们销售直接的话，应该这个处理起来。
这是客户觉得销售那个处理起来是更畅通，但是从职责而言是客户的职责。理由这样子啊，从客户的心态，从客户的心态 ，from the customer's point of view， 客户不是跟你的公司买，客户是跟你买你们公司的产品。Right, customers don't buy from your company, customers buy from you for your company's products.Okay, 这是客户的心态，因为客户的一个心态是你忽悠我的，对吧？出了事你和你负责呀。这是客户的一个。
请问一下，像这个调查结果是中国的市场上这样，还是全球都？
全球都这样。全球都这样。中国可能更明显。 这群众的 this global, this is global. Alright, so that is why I think customers want you to take care of everything. This is global. 那么这位是 you need to understand the customer's business, 要了解够的一个商务的一个情况。Which is why, as technical sales, sometimes we are overly technical and too little on business results. 有些时候我们帮客户解决的是技术问题，而忘了你到底要给他带来怎么样的一个商务方面的一个益处。技术问题解决了，但是商务益处呢？你可能解决一个技术问题，你要花很大的一个这个本钱税，完结果是不合算的。But some technical problems can resolve at huge costs, which the customer cannot accept because you need to understand the business. We have an old story, German World War II story actually, about not understanding the business. Now, 我们二战的时候，二战的时候最牛的这个牛叉的这个坦克是哪里？德国坦克，the best tanks in World War II, Panzers and Tiger tanks, right? 那为什么到了后来，就是说坦克却败给了那个巴顿的那个就是美国坦克 ？Why is it the best tanks in World lost to the tanks, the Sherman tanks of Patton, George Patton? 为什么？几个方面啊，一个是没油 ，one is the ran out of fuel，right？ 一个 great tank but got no fuel， 就是这个原因。Let's take one step back and understand Sherman tanks， 就美国坦克是到底多烂，粗制滥造。Right， Sherman tanks， if you have the German tank and an American tank in World War II， and you go face to face， 如果一个德国坦克、美国坦克在面对面 PK。美国坦克基本上叫九死一生 out of ten times the American tank will be blown to pieces 有没有人看到一个愤怒 Fury 一辆德国坦克基本上可以干掉四五辆那个美国坦克就基本上是真实情况 One German tank is able to take down between 4 to 5 Sherman tanks at the same time 基本上有那么大一个优势那为什么会那个失败呢除了呢他们有拦阻还有
数量
太少 The numbers are too few For a German tank to be manufactured Each part that goes into the tank Has got a lifespan of 50 years 每个零件就是每个德国坦克零件的寿命是50年你一个坦克上了战场它能耐多久可能3天可能1周可能2周反正就报废掉了对吧？这是你的那个情景不合适。The lifespan of tank in the battlefield probably is a matter of days or weeks。所以你那个过度的那什么，你的那个 spec in 过度的那个什么，严重超标。Right? American tanks 呢 ？What is the typical lifespan of the American tank？ 那美国坦克的那个使用周期大概多少？不知道。因为他们的一个思路是这样子的，只需要坦克投入战场，回不回来无所谓。Right, we only need to commit the tanks into the battlefield. Whether they come back alive or not, it doesn't really matter. Right, 就 their disposal， 就可以就是说报废掉。Right, 所以这样子的话就是什么？从数量角度，让美国坦克的数量特别多啊，你那个什么一辆那个。德国坦克能够就是灭掉你那个4到5辆那个美国坦克，如果第6辆，这个就不是玩完了。这个所以这就是什么不了解商务模式，当然他当时是不了解那个战争模式。但从现在的那个销售，你要考虑到不是简单的技术，而是要了解客户的一个商务模式，一个 understand the business need。还有主动为客户提出建议 ，proactively provide advice for the customer。我们有时候就是什么做，尤其技术型销售，就是过于那个含蓄，过于内向。所以客户有些不理解东西，我们要跟他们说，我说还那个什么，太内向，不好意思说。啊，这是我们需要的很多。Sometimes, technical sales sometimes are a little overly introverted, so we don't really proactively provide funds, they are reactively providing funds. 然后呢，就我们需要就是 suggest the right solution that solve the customer problem， 就提供能解决客户困惑的有效方案。这一点，技术销售的强项。This is a key strength of technical sales. Usually we know how to solve problems, and that's what we are trained for. 这是一个主要的一个核心能力。那 B is accessible to 随时能够联系上，其实大家都知道，什么随时你的手机啊，这个那个什么。 微信啊，还有大家所有的那个通讯，基本上都需要能够联系得上。然后呢 ，be creative in responding to customers' needs， 为客户的这个需求提出有创意的解决方法。有些时候正规的方法、遵规中矩的方法不一定能行，有些时候需要你去跟其他部门协商、跟老板协商、跟就是找一些就是非标的工作，啊，这才能解决。这方面。 For this part, the creative, you need to work a customized solution for customers' needs. For this part, usually Chinese companies are strong. European companies are weak. 通常你要去创业，还是量身定造啊，比较灵活啊，各位要怎么整都可以怎么整啊。那就是内资品牌可能在这方面会比较有一个优势。 欧资品牌在这方面可能就比较硬的生意，过度的这个inflexible。We're not saying that you need to be very flexible like local companies， 我们不需要就是像那些企业那么就过度的一个怎么整都可以。那有些时候呢，可能需要我们做一些调整。She said sometimes you need to be flexible enough to meet the customer's needs。 这就是我们需要就是。 前面就是去理解的。OK。茶其实就是在。行。啊，可以了。可以是吧？OK。所以，我 won't go into here because I think it's time for dinner. We know that without coffee and without cigarette, sometimes we cannot function. 就是做，如果人是一台那个设备的话。 这个投入嘛，少了这个咖啡因也少了尼古丁，好像这个 output 就基本上就没办法，这两点呢都得保证，所以这两点呢都得保证。就休息个15分钟，现在是3:20，我们那个，对，45分钟，35分钟，35分钟。
客户家搞的，我们是钱自己付吗？
是不是自己付？
啊？
滴滴电子，这三个。
350。